We have to perhaps look at the influence of AI and data centers. They're consuming massive amounts of energy, and that's pretty concerning to the rest of the world. How might that add to energy demand?
Yeah, so AI is, of course, very topical nowadays, and we look today of the entire electricity consumption, the share of AI, because electricity is consumed for lighting, for electric cars, for refrigerators, everything. The share of AI is less than today 1% in the global electricity mix. It will grow, but it will not grow globally. There will be some the regional. It can be in Wyoming, it can be in Singapore, it can be in this or that country. So globally, it will not be a major game changer, but it will add to the electricity demand globally.
In addition to
many other drivers I mentioned.
And is there a percentage? Is there a number you can give us in terms of how it would boost energy demand by 2%?
I think it is still
3%?
Too early to give a number, but today it is only 1% of the global electricity consumption. It will not be a big game changer. But what is a game changer is, electricity is used more and more in everything, in the cars, in industry, at home. So what we are seeing is, we had after this the industrial revolution, we have seen the age of coal, and we are now seeing the age of oil. We are still there; it will be with us oil many years to come. But the world gives the signal that we are entering the age of electricity. Electricity will be more pronounced than maybe oil and gas. We talk about the oil prices. We will, in the future, we may talk about the electricity prices.
But isn't it the age of nuclear power? We've had the likes of Taiwan saying they're open to it. We're seeing the U.S. changing its stance on it. We're looking at Japan and Korea, pretty open to it as well. I mean, how do you talk about AI without talking about nuclear power?
You are right. I mean, if we say the age of electricity is starting, there are mainly two sources to meet that demand from electricity. One is renewables, the other one is nuclear power. I am seeing that in the entire world, the nuclear makes a very strong comeback, both in terms of the large-scale power plants that we have seen in the U.S., in Japan, and elsewhere. And the second, more and more interest in the small modular reactors, smaller version and more flexible version of the nuclear. So nuclear is making a comeback. There is no question about that. The countries that have nuclear power plants, they are extending the lifetimes of the nuclear power plants, building new ones. And many countries who never had a nuclear power plant in their countries are now planning to build nuclear power plants, because nuclear power generates electricity without any interruption. You push the button 24/7, no emissions, and it's a very secure one. So,
but there are risks to nuclear power.
There are risks to everything.
How does it shape? How does it shape the energy mix?
I expect that the nuclear will grow, and our numbers show 2025. Next year, we will see the highest nuclear power generation in the history. And this is a good thing, I believe, for the world. But we should also note that in the last 5 years, about 80% of all new nuclear power plants built in the world was in China. 20% everybody has put together, China alone 80%. But I expect now it is going to change. And in the United States, in Europe, in Asia, we will see, in Africa, we will see a new nuclear power to be built. But for the nuclear power plants, you need many years to finish a project. If it is solar for 2 years, nuclear takes at least 10-15 years.
How are you assessing the risk of nuclear power? If a country like Japan can have accidents, some say perhaps emerging economies may find it difficult monitoring, keeping a lid on troubles that could appear from having nuclear power in the country.
But to build a nuclear power plant, you cannot build a nuclear power plant just you are building a cottage. You nuclear power plant, there are some international rules and regulations. There are safety rules, and they are very strict. And the governments need to take all of this into consideration to be able to get a permission to build a nuclear power plant. So there are safety rules there. But the problem is, for me, for the nuclear, the biggest challenge today in front of nuclear, how are we going to finance nuclear power plants? Because their financement is very, very high. The down payment is very high. It is the reason we are coming with a new report mid-January, how to finance nuclear power plants in this age, because it is different in China, but different in the rest of the world, how you finance these huge projects which require a lot of capital.